Okay.
Welcome to episode one. Right. Cheers.
So, Nick, tell us a bit about this wine
that we opened on. This is something that we've completely cocked up.
Okay, so this is a spectacular drop. I bought from a fantastic retailer in Adelaide about 20 years ago. It's a 1990 Bollinger, A Rouge Le Cote aux Enfants. Effectively is a Pinot Noir. We had a hilarious thing on Saturday night where I thought it was actually a champagne. And so we popped the cork, it had absolutely no fizz.
So to give an idea, it came in a cork like that.
Yeah.
So this cork has a closure, so it went in top with a very much like a carver bottle.
Yeah.
So we weren't to know that it was a still wine.
No, absolutely weren't to know. It's also in a champagne bottle, if anyone's interested in noticing that.
Who would have thunk it?
And it also turns out that it's so rare that there's absolutely nothing on the internet about it. So we come into East End Cellars in Adelaide, in the tasting room today. And this one is from 2013.
Yeah.
Plenty about this one, but nothing mentioning that it's a still wine. So at any rate...
So what did we do on Saturday night?
Saturday night, we thought it was a piece of shit, and we said to everybody, it's gone. It needs to go in the bin, basically. One of our dear friends, Andrew Williams, who you'll meet during these episodes, he had a taste of it about 2 hours later, given it was refrigerated and it had been in the bottle for 28 years. And he said, well, this tastes all right. But no one gave me any credence, because by that stage I think we were on the scotches and the cognacs. Anyhow, 9 a.m. on Monday morning, I walk into East End Cellars. I hand the bottle over to the experts here. I receive an email 6 or 7 hours later saying, actually, Nick, it's a still bottle of wine, and it's amazing. Get your ass in here and start drinking it. And so here we are.
So just to emphasise that we are not complete knuckleheads, although that could be described. But Nick, how would you describe the wine when we tasted it first as opening immediately? What was your feeling when you opened the wine?
I had a terrible nose. It smelled like it had been in a bottle for 28 years. And there was very
little...
No bubbles.
And which is what we were expecting, of course.
But now it is an exceptionally... silky, velvety, soft Pinot. It's possibly one of the most delicate wines I've drunk. It feels like it's breaking apart in your mouth as you drink it. It has an acidic flavour that reveals the plum notes. It is not great on the nose, but it does have a spectacular flavour in the mouth.
So I disagree. So first of all, when I tasted it on Saturday night, I thought it tasted shit. So to me, when I first tasted it, it had a bit of that flavour of a pickled carrot. So, and I know that sounds
very
a bit
regular,
weird.
Very big in wine.
You'll see that on the back of wine labels and all that sort of stuff. But it tasted like
that.
A pickled carrot.
I've never heard of pickled carrot, I've got to say.
But you don't want your 28-year-old Pinot to taste like a pickled carrot. I might add that. Anyway, but it was a cold pickled carrot as well. That was the worst bit about this flavour.
We had refrigerated it on the basis that we thought it was lucky we didn't have it in the freezer, as a matter of fact.
Now, having had the wine after it's been opened, but has been recorked and also has been supported by our good fellows here at the
East End Cellars
in Adelaide. But tasting again, for me... I quite like the nose. I think it tastes...
Doesn't give me anything.
For me, it's got a bit of a chocolate nose.
It's very savoury. Very savoury.
Yeah. So he's savoury, I'm a bit chocolate. But I'm a very sweet person. So to me, that's very good. And I quite like it.
There's a velvetness. There's a velvetiness to it.
There's the sour cherries. And
definitely sour cherries.
But it's really nice. It's very delicate. Very lovely. It tastes very good. And it's lucky that we didn't pour it down the sink, as many people do. And so I can recommend, when you're at a dinner party and you've tasted a wine that you think is corked, because you're a dick, hold the horses and put the cork back in.
But there is a super added element to this. There is a super added element to today, which is that having come in here, oddly enough, East End Cellars, the tasting room, had a... bottle of the same wine, but 2013. So we have taken it upon ourselves to try this one as well.
So we'll show you the
label. The label. Yeah.
So it's a little bit different from the previous label.
Which I think the previous label is far, far more mercurial than the current one.
They've kept the same closure though.
Same closure.
So they still have the same closure, which goes up the top.
This wine is much more of a, I'd say, a classic Pinot. It's beautiful peppery. It's not a, you know, it's clearly it's French. It's made in the Pinot styles, but it's not a Domaine Romanée Conti. It's not a DRC. However, because it is an outlier, because it is made at a much cooler climate vineyard than DRC, it's a different type of wine, but it is exceptionally well balanced. Huge flavors of plum. I'm getting very much Satsuma plum flavors. It's a much, much bigger wine in its infancy. Far better bouquet on the nose. Over to you.
Well, so what I'd say, the difference between this wine and the previous wine is the first thing I see is that the younger wine is a different color. The older wine from 1990 has got a brown color, and there's a little bit of sediment in the bottom, which is okay. It's not harsh. It's very subtle though. The younger wine is purple. It is a really nice purple.
Beautiful.
It looks very refined.
Viscosity is much higher as well.
Yeah, it's quite nice. And for me, the flavour is just really good.
It's beautiful.
Now we've had this open for 2 hours, and it's taken the 2 hours to get down
to really get to this
really
peak
to that
flavour.
Nice space.
Yep.
And also, I might point out, we had it in a wine cellar, so it was cold, and we had issues when we first tasted it. Quite had the flavour that it should have done.
It's definitely come right up now. Definitely
you need to get
right
down
up.
that really nice room temperature.
It's got to get up to room temperature. All right. Well, that is installment one.
So which one would you have?
I'd still go with the 1990. I mean, I think that the excitement of drinking something that was opened in 1990 and drinking something that has so much history, I guess, in the bottle. 28 years. I'd always go for that. But in terms of the wine, I think they're different, but equally as beautiful.
So the lesson I take away from this today is that if you bring a bottle of wine that is worth a significant amount of money to a dinner party, I'd recommend opening it, pretending that it is bad, putting a cork back in it, and then having it with the person you want to drink it with, and then you get half the bottle each. It is a much better way of drinking a very expensive wine, and then you don't have to share it.
Yes. Well, that is a good outtake from this one. That's a good outtake from
well
this
done,
one.
Nick. Llewellyn. Well done. Excellent.
Cheers.
Cheers.
To the 1990.
Cheers.